So let's talk anatomy, specifically anatomy that pertains to us cosmetologists. We have the license to touch, so having an understanding of the bones and the muscles allows us to safely and effectively perform services while keeping our own body in a healthy working condition. Starting with the skeletal system, at the top we have our skull, and that's broken into two categories, our cranial bones and our facial skeleton. Our cranial bones are what we know as our reference points. These are areas on the head that change shape and affect how the hair moves and lays. From the frontal bone, the occipital, the parietal, and the temporal, these are all bones we know. The ethmoid is a spongy bone on the inner eye socket and helps form the nasal cavities. The sphenoid is a wing-like bone that connects all the bones of the cranium together. Think of it as that last puzzle piece. The facial skeleton is made up of 14 bones. This determines your face shape for design, cuts, colors, and makeup. Nasal forms the bridge of your nose. Lacrimal is in front of the ethmoid, and that forms the front of the eye socket. Maxillae is your upper jaw. Mandible is your lower jaw, which is the strongest bone in your face. And then your zygomatic are your cheekbones. Below that is our hyoid. This is a U-shaped bone that supports our tongue. Without this bone, our tongue would be like a dog's tongue. Below that is our cervical vertebrae. This is the vertebrae that lives on our neck, and we have 7 of them. Next, we have our thorax. This is known as the trunk or the chest. It is made to protect our organs. It consists of our ribs and our sternum, which is our breastbone, to our scapulas, which are our shoulder blades, moving on to our clavicle, which is our collarbone. Continuing down the arm, we have our humerus. This is the largest bone in the arm, from our shoulder to our elbow. Past our elbow, we have our forearm, and that consists of our ulna and our radius. Our ulna is a larger bone on the pinky side, and our radius is the smaller bone on the thumb side. Below that, we have our carpus. This is our wrist, made up of 8 small irregular bones, to our metacarpus, which is our palm, and we have 5, to our digits or our phalanges, which are our fingers. Moving to the leg and the feet, we have our femur. This is the large, heavy bone that sits above the knee, considered our thigh bone. To our movable joint, which is our kneecap, also known as the patella. Below that is our tibia and our fibula. Tibia is our shin bone. It is the larger bone of our lower leg. Fibula is considered the calf bone, and that is the smaller bone of the lower leg. To our tarsal, which makes up our ankle bone. To our metatarsal, which is the palm of our feet. And then our phalanges, which are our digits or our toes. Moving on to the muscular system, we're going to begin by talking about the muscles of the face. So first we have our frontalis, covers the frontal bone, allows us to raise our eyebrows up and create horizontal wrinkles. Next is our orbicularis oculi. This is the ring around the eye, and that allows our eyelids to close. Then we have our corrugator. That is between the eyebrow, draws our eyebrows down, and creates vertical wrinkles. Our procurius is the bridge of our nose, allows us to wrinkle our nose. And then our buccinator is part of our mouth, allows us to expel air or to whistle. Next is our depressor labii inferioris, draws our lip down to one side. Above is our levator angular oris, and that's going to raise the corner of the mouth. Next is our levator labii superioris, and that's going to allow both sides of our upper lip to raise together. Below that on our chin is our mentalis. That elevates our lower lip and wrinkles our chin. Orbicularis oris is around our mouth, and that allows our lips to pucker. Our Azorius draws out the corners of our mouth in a grin. Triangularis is on each side of our lips, and that draws the corners of our mouth down. And then we have our zygomatic, which is our cheeks, and that allows us to laugh and to smile. Moving to the muscles of the ear, we have our superior, our posterior, and our anterior. Auricular, or A-U-R, always refers to the ear. Superior is above, posterior is behind, anterior is in front. Then we have our platysma and our sternocleidomastoideus. These are the muscles that allow us to move our neck forward and rotate our head side to side. And now on to the rest of the body. So starting at the top, we're going to begin with the trapezius. This is our trap muscle or our upper back. This allows our head and neck to rotate freely, giving us full range of motion. Our pec or our pectoralis is our chest. This aids in swinging our arm. Our deltoid is our shoulder. This allows us to raise our arm out to the side. Our serratus anterior is part of our ribs and our rib cage. That assists us in breathing and raising our hand above our head. Our bicep lifts our forearm. Our tricep is the back of the arm. Our lat is a large back muscle, gives us full range of motion of our shoulder mobility, and that could be circular or back and forth. Next, we have our extensor. This extends our arm, our elbow, and our fingers into a nice straight line. Then we have pronator and supinator. Pronator is going to face our palm down. Supinator is going to face our palm up. And then flexor is part of our wrist. That allows us to rotate and move our wrist around. Moving to the leg and the feet, we're starting with the gastrocnemius. This is a long muscle in the back of the leg, extends down to the bottom of the heel, allows us to basically walk, so it pulls our heel up and down. Next is going to be our tibial. This is going to cover our shin, and that is going to pull our foot up and in, aiding us and assisting us in walking. Next is the peroneus brevis and the peroneus longus. These are the sides of the calf muscle. These allow our ankle joint mobility, moving from side to side, in and out. Next is the solus. This starts in the fibula down to the foot, and that's going to bend the foot down, helping us as we walk. Next is the extensor hallucis longus. Hallucis for big toe, so it's going to flex our big toe. Then we have our flexor digitorum brevis. This is going to help move all of our toes. Then we have our flexor digiti minimi. This is going to move our pinky toe. And then our abductor hallucis, that's for our big toe. That's going to give us balance as we're walking and standing. And then our abductor digiti minimi is for our pinky side, and that also aids us in walking and standing to give us full balance. So that's it, from the bones to the muscles. Happy studying!